Hello and welcome, Doom Riders, to another broadcast of Building on the Fly. I've already set this corner piece out, and I think maybe we should build, I don't know, an armory. How about that? We'll just use the Vault Tech atrium. It'll either be an armory or maybe a power station. Well, we'll see. That's what it's like when you build on the fly. Alright, let's get these floors down. Alright, that looks good. Let's see here. Let's find us some walls. Get some corner pieces up. Alright, that's looking good. Now, shall we make this two-story, three-story? Yeah, we'll find out here in a second. Alright. I think we need a door. See how that looks. I don't think I like that. We'll get rid of that. Now, like I said in my last episode, I was thinking about making a centralized power station for the town. This looks kind of small. I think we can do it, though. You'll have to forgive me for my voice and such. I've been sick. So we'll do the best I can. Let's get some windows in here. Alright, let's see. So now, let's get some more flooring down. Maybe. Well, now we just gotta find something that works. Interesting. These should work. Huh, nothing's clipping. Interesting. Okay, let's try something else then, since that's not working. Alright, I think I got a plan here. This is what I was talking about with the snapping system in this game. Sometimes it is really wacky. Alright, so we'll take out this floor piece for now. And then we will clip that in place. And that should allow us to clip. Hmm. All right. This is a little confusing, but we'll get it done. All right, let's try this one. There we go. Just like that. All right, so you'll need this post to build like this if you want to do that, apparently. That's how they have these Vault-Tec ones, so now we can go ahead. And build. First, I need to get this wall in. All right. Now we're talking. Since we're going to make this more than one story, we're going to have to add stairs. Wonder if anything else will clip on here. All right. Interesting. Whoop. Now let's try to get those stairs in. Oh, wait, let's put the glass in first. There we go. Now we'll try to get the stairs in. All right, it still clips. Looks a little weird, but it works. All right, it's not going to give us much real estate to work with. What do you think? We think we should expand here. All I'm thinking we should expand. Cooking. Now we're doing some good shit here. That should give us some more real estate to work with. I mean, this is a big settlement, so the settlement's going to have a big armory or big power supply. Why not both? We could make an armory and a power supply. How about that? Put the power on the top floor. Well, we could always expand it. See what that looks like real quick. Yeah, that's not gonna work. All right, so much for that idea. All right, here we go. Corner pieces. Oh yeah. Now we're getting it together here. Instead of having the access to the power supply come through the building here, through the armory, why don't we build like a side entrance with the staircase here. So we'll do that in a minute. Let's get the rest of this set up for an armory. Decided to use the Vault-Tec because, well, why not? Most people don't. I figured maybe they just stripped it out of the top up there. Took it from Vault 111 up there. You know what? It's an armory. We shouldn't have a lot of windows in it. May not be that aesthetic pleasing to the outside, but we can decorate that up later. You gotta love this clipping system. We'll leave the one window right here. Ah, clip, come on. All right, just like before, we're gonna have to put in one of those little pillars. There we go. It's Let's go and see about the generators here. We'll put in one of these. See if that'll clip on there. Nope. Alright. No problem. We can solve that problem. Maybe. Come on. There we go. Alright, now we'll get this up here. And then we'll pull this out. Put it right there. Alright. We will leave that column in. And maybe... yeah. We'll put in a second column for structural support. I know you don't have to, but yeah, it's just to make it look good. There we go. So now we gotta figure out where we're gonna have the door. So the door coming from this side. I was just seeing if there was any corners with the, yeah, let's try this. This'll work. Let's get rid of that. That. Alright, now we got this working right here. Now we're talking. There's that one with the door. Door there. There we go. But I think we're gonna need to move this more into the center. Alright, we got the power up. Now we're kind of wedged in here. How would it be like if we didn't have those in here? Alright. All right, we need to take out these walls. You'll see why in a minute why I took out those walls. So it's going to be that one wall. Okay, there we go. We'll leave that window and that window. All right, so that's the door. What if we... Yeah, that's not gonna work. Unless... Alright, I think I have to put one of these door caps on it for it to snap on. These Vault-Tec ones are a little harder to use than your vanilla stuff. Now let's see if that works. I might have to turn it around, I'm not sure. There we go. Yeah, you gotta get those. Make sure to get those door caps on there. Where is it? There we go. Yeah, there we go. Now, should we have it coming out like that? Kind of wrapping around the building. Have a wrap around the building. Now let's, I think we need to put a door cap. We need some tiny stairs or something. All right, now let's see if we can get a door in there. There you go. What do we think about that? That's not too shabby, huh? Get some support in there. Maybe. That's gonna kind of bug me. Let's put in like a foundation floor here. That lined up. Watch, it'll interfere with that going up there. I just have this feeling. So touchy. Ah, I knew it. That's as low as it'll sink in the ground. See if it works with this one. There we go. Ah. Needs to come over a little bit. Alright, there we go. Okay. Let's go up and see what our power plant's like. Yeah, not too bad, not too bad. Oh, what are we gonna do about this, though? Let's see. I think we're gonna have to that's not gonna clip on there like that, so I think we're gonna have to try to find a way. Yeah, we're gonna have to build it. All right. To use these walls here. These are cap walls. Alright, well, I think the only way we can really get up this is we need to get up in there. Get on the top. Get a better angle at it from the top. Alrighty. Use my place anywhere mod. Alright. Yeah, that's gonna stick out the top. So I think we're gonna have to we're going to have to use different pieces here. Get one of these. Now we should be able to place some of these on up here. Yeah, there we go. The only thing I can think to do is just to build another room up here just for that. Just so we can cap it off. Like that. All right, now we're cooking. All right. This little idea is starting to turn out pretty good. Now we just need some kind of roof. I think I got an idea. Might look cool. Be a little difficult to do, but I think we can do it. We'll see what your opinions are on it. If we can get out there. Just need a ladder. All right. What if we used... Oop, I must be out of the building area here. Interesting. So this is as high as you can build. It's Sanctuary Hills. Alright. Well, what I was going to do, before I was so rudely interrupted by the game's limit here, was use the warehouse ceiling and try to put like a glass window up there. Now, I can probably still do it from here. I don't know if I'll be able to line it up the way we should, but let's give it a shot. I mean, trial and error is what this is all about. Like, so you kind of lay it down like this. Make sure it's all lined up good. We'll use it in here first. see if we like it. Hey, what do you guys think? Yeah, that's not too bad. I might be able just to eliminate this whole room right here, this unnecessary room. Maybe. All right, let's try something real quick here. Keep with the Vault-Tec theme here. I apologize if the commentary is not as good as I usually am, but I am on three different types of medications. So it's kind of messing with me a little bit here. But I think we're going to like this better. Alright, there we go. There we go. I kind of like that. What do you guys think? Alright. Now that we got that all taken care of. Alright, up there's our power plant. Right here's our armory. So, let's label it as such. What do you think, red? Oh, the R doesn't want to pop out there. This might be a little harder than I thought. Let's put it on the here then. All right, let's center that out a little better. All right, let's get some power up in here. Now, the cool thing about these Vault-Tec walls and power supply is you don't have to run power everywhere. All you need to do is have the power hooked up under the stair right there. And then attach one of these to the wall. Has to be a flat wall. Now that should do it. Let me see here. Interesting. All right. So you can't place them on the outside. It will not let you place them. Unless you turn the wall on the other side inside out. But I can't place one there. Okay, yeah, this is... Okay, now all you gotta do is attach this wire to there. And that should set us up with power. But why stop there? Why not go here? Since nobody's supposed to be up in here anyway. Alright, that won't reach. It's too long, it says. Alright. We'll put one over here. Why not? And now we need to get some windows in here. And a door. Some security windows in. Kind of looks good, in my own opinion. Alright. Now, I'm not 100% sure, but that should be providing electricity to this room here. Yeah, see? All you had to do was put one of those on the wall and attach it, and then it runs through the walls anywhere you have these. I don't know if you can attach it to the outside of those windows or those walls, but let's give it a try. If so, that's going to make it a lot easier. If not, I'll just get a conduit and stick it in there. I'll show you how to do that. Ah, there we go. So now we can start wiring the town that way. That's weird, it'll let that one, but this one doesn't want to attach. There we go. You gotta get it way up there. Alright. So now, I think all we'd have to do is run some light poles. What kind do you think we should use here? One there. One there. All right, now see, we can use these poles to run power all over town. Just like they do in your local town now. Sorry, that was bothering me. It looked a little uneven. Alright, yeah, see? That's how we can do that. Alright, let's get some steps up here, because this doorway is getting in my way here. All we need is these little concrete steps. Make sure they're lined upright. Use place anywhere mod. There we go. All right, well, we're going to need some lighting in here if we're going to use this as an armory. So, let's, let's add some of these in here. They really don't light up too well, do they? Let's try. Let's try these. I'm just going to place these here for now. And then I'll come back in and align everything. Alright. So that's the only problem with some of this Vault-Tec stuff. It's a little touchy. Like when you go to move the light, it wants to go out of the area. That's fine. When I put the racks up, I like to put track lighting up. And it makes it like a spotlight on the guns. Just kind of cool. And here we got these little yellow boxes to help guide us. Yeah, those Vault-Tec conduits over here, these things are great. If you guys are know anything about stringing up the power in these things, it can get monotonous putting all the little conduits down, stringing them around. All right, that'll work for now. All right, well, that's pretty much all we have to do, but it doesn't make it an armory yet, now does it? So come in here. Start at the top here. So we got one row of rifles, one row of pistols. Let's do like where we would put our snipers. Alright, and then go for two rows of those. Like your Goss weapons and such. Let's inch that up more. Alright, there we go. Now we're cooking, right? Stick another row of rifles. Okay, I was just checking it. It looked like maybe it wasn't flush to the wall. Now we'll have a row of handguns. And then we'll get another little group of handguns right there, handgun racks. Yeah, I don't like that. And then we'll just get like, maybe a couple heavy weapons racks right here. There we go. All right. I like to use the most out of my wall space. Since this is a big settlement. If I can get it to cooperate. Ah, it's so touchy. Let's go with a couple more of these racks. Right around the conduit here. And then just for a little change here. Put a couple of those in. Yeah, I don't like that. Maybe with these wired mesh ones. Up in there. Yeah, that gives it more of a balancing look to it. Alright, let's just change things up. Let's put some handguns here. And just like we did over there, try to put these big ones in. As you can tell, this is going to be a massive armory. These settlers, once this is fully up is going to be a force to contend with. All right, there we go. And then just a couple single ones, right? If it'll let me. Oh, you. Alright, there we go. And then we'll put a couple just single ones right there. Maybe a couple of heavy weapons here in the middle. We'll put up some ammo containers and such. All right, what are we gonna do in here? How about some power armor? Maybe one here. And, how about one in each corner here? Let's get some, conduits up here. That way we don't have to run. There we go. Okay, I got some dips. So you got some power armor display cases. About some mannequins. Display some armor. Now some gals. Guess it's going to be guys and gals. Alright, not too bad. Let's see if we got anything in here. Let's go to do it your shelf. Let's just start ammoing it up, right? Yeah, that's nice, see? So I was talking about that do-it-yourself is very convenient if you wanted to make it look very lived in. Let's get some on the wall here. Get some armor. Let's get rid of that one. Let's get some variety up in here. All right, there we go. Now all we have to do is armor all of them up. Alright. Now, I'm going to show you what I do with the track lighting. Which kind of makes it look like you're putting a little spotlights on your armor and your weapons displays here. Alright, we get them up here. I don't know if they'll stick. There you go. Just like that. You can also use these single ones. Place them on the ground. Like that. But they work better for weapons displays. So I usually use those on the big heavy weapons. Whoops. Why not highlight some of this, right? There we go. See, just with the little bit of lighting and you leave some of the shadows, it really plays off the dark and the light. Like right here, if you wanted to put them on the ground, like so. Apparently I'm not getting any power to this ground here, but I am right there. And we can change that real quick. Putting one of these conduits up should work. Huh. All right. We'll just put it up there. And then we'll put our display back over here. All right. And let's do the same thing with the lighting down here. center it more. All right, there we go. So that's pretty much the whole armory. And it's not fully decorated. I'm not going to bore you with doing all that. But I probably will decorate it all up and arm it up. And then we can. I'll show you on the next build with all the weapons and everything in there. All right. And that's pretty much it except for slapping on some signage and everything. But there we go. We got an armory and a town power supply, you know, centralized power supply that we're going to use these to run all over town to bring the power to all the houses and buildings that we build. I think that's about all we need to do. Let me come up here and check so you can see the power supply again. And I really like using these little glass windows here. Since you can't place any floors or anything there because this supposedly gets in the way, you can do it like that. And it kind of puts a little flair, a little style on it. You can open up your core here. You got power to go. All I got to do is decorate it up and put up some signage. But I don't think you want to see me do all that. There we go. Power plant and an armory. Done in mere minutes. And now we have a power source for town and a weapon supply for the settlers when they come in. And of course, there's our building that we made the last time that I decorated and built for you. So that's what all we have today. I hope you enjoyed this. If so, if you're watching this on my YouTube, like, subscribe. I'm going to be putting out a lot more videos, a lot more of this and the other stuff I do on my channel, like Skyrim mods and Gears of War 4 gameplay and tips. All right. Until the next time, this is Deathlord76 signing off for Doom Riders, and I'm out of here. Hello, everybody. Welcome back. I thought I'd show you real quick. I kitted this out. I'm going to add this onto the other video that I just recorded, but I wanted to show you that it looks good as you kit it out. Now, I put this chain link fence around here. I got this out of a mod. I kind of like it. You'd want to keep your important buildings off of here. And I got these signs, restricted area, electrical. Now, I didn't get all the weapons like I told you before. This is a fresh start character, but I put a guard post out front and some signage. And I just wanted to show you real quick to add this onto the other video, the end here. And here's what it looks like with some weapons, some posters. I haven't got it all kitted out, but I wanted to show you what it'd be like. Just a little decor. And I added some more of these poles down here. As you can see, that's where I'm going to start wiring up that house we built. And we'll come around here. Just a quick glance. Added the reactor sign, the nuclear sign. These little computers, some signs here. And that's what it looks like when you want to put a little decoration in it. All right, that's all I wanted to show you real quick. Just a little add-on. I like these little chain fences that came with this mod. Kind of makes it look nice. Okay, thank you for watching. And this is Deathlord76. Now I'm out of here.